Capital city of Lisbon and the northwestern port city of Oporto, representing here different identities and values and cultures, a rivalry between the two big cities of the nation. No surprise then that feelings run high when they meet over a football match. Red on blue and white, eagle on dragon. It doesn't take too much imagination to understand how big this is. Fueled by so many factors, both on and off the field, it is one of those games in Portuguese cultural and sporting society. It is a venue, this, which simply adds to the spectacle of the game it stages. One of the most impressive arenas in this part of the world. And it's as friendly as it can be in the circumstances. You feel the rivalry.
I'm sitting here, Peter, thinking, is it possible for these two to meet under friendly circumstances? This exhibition match is likely to exist.
There's a pop!
Save, absolutely sparkling. His reflexes were ultra sharp.
It's a clearance, but not much of one. Pixie. Across the field it goes.
It's a busy front line, lots of movement.
And is that working for you?
Well, not really. To be honest, I'm not a great fan of taking goal potential away from the penalty box.
He wasn't very far from making something happen by himself. Lovely to see. Pixie. To locate someone up front. If anyone is going to break the deadlock, now would be a good time. He's got options out wide.
All he'd be thinking is, please, Graham, swallow me up.
Rafa Silva. Referee's had a look, and he's blown his whistle for half-time. Well, both sides have drawn blanks and have toiled at times, but it's not been a bad game by anybody's. The opinion you'd like to express on the first half?
Yeah, the scoreline doesn't tell the whole story, as one side has been significantly better, at least defensively.
So they head in no further forward. The score here, still 0-0. They're probably into the second 45 minutes.
Porto playing well with lots of opportunities and plenty positives to take from the first half, despite the scoreline, converting chances.
Goes for goal!
Are really pouncing on any straight passes in midfield. We're talking seconds from interception to the back of the net. It's counter-attacking heavily.
Porto take the lead, landing the first significant blow in what is certainly a significant contest.
Because of that first goal now, it's a great opportunity.
And a foul? Yes, the referee's given it. And no surprise, that's a booking. Can get it clear. And it's played forward. He's in! He's gone for it! Goal!
And this is getting better and better.
Now looking back at that, that's how you play on the counter. Quick and decisive and ruthless with the finish. I thought it was a stunning, stunning breakaway.
Porto take a two-goal lead, and things should be comfortable from here on in.
Well, they're very much the better team at the moment, Peter, and no doubt we'll be looking to cause even more damage here.
And the weighted pass,
and it's got through.
It's a very good effort. There wasn't much wrong with that at all. We're talking fine margins now.
Alex Telles. Forward it goes. Here it comes. Danilo Pereira. Shapes to shoot!
Well, that's why we all say indecision is fatal.
Jota.
Leading by two and the finishing line in sight. And here's the chance to counter. Is there, and he can get that clear.
A really good feat.
The assistant referee rightly gives him offside. Ivan Marcano. And there goes the final whistle. Porto did it. Terrific team effort to satisfy both the boss and the fans. Now, how will we look back on that?
Porto made their intentions clear.